All right, welcome to The Trouble with Covered Calls, Part 3. What's possible? Well, how about this? Instead of selling somebody the right to buy our stock out from under us at their price, when it's to their advantage, how about we buy the right to sell it at our price when we want to instead? The put option gives you the right, but not the obligation, to sell at a certain price, right? That's the privilege you pay for when you buy a put option. Now, when most folks think of put options, they think that you'd only buy those when you're bearish on a stock. After all, the value of a put option goes up when the stock goes down. So if you're buying puts, you want the stock to crash, right? Not necessarily. In fact, on Wall Street, it's considered a bullish sign, a stock gonna go up kind of a sign, when institutional investors begin to buy puts on it. Why is that? Well, it's because rather than selling those stocks that they've got, they're holding. They're buying a little bit of insurance, an insurance policy in case the rest of the market goes against their position, but their bet is that they won't. Buying puts on Wall Street is a bullish sign for the stock. Interesting. Why don't small investors do that? If the big ones that we trust our money to, and the mutual funds, if the money managers are doing it, why don't we know about it? It's not sexy. It's not like covered calls, where you take a risk and collect money into your account right now. No, with a put option, you pay up front. But I kind of like that. I kind of like that I know exactly how big of a hit I might take. Now, I'm going to show you a trade I got into. Today is January 31st. I got into this and sent out an email on my website on January 11th. And then 2 weeks later, I made this trade bulletproof. Let's take a look. We bought 200 shares of ValueClick at $23.20 the two a piece. The total there is $46.40. And bought to open, that's what BTO is, bought to open to June 2007 $25 put options that cost $3.30. For those of you that are savvy about options, this is an in-the-money option. And I like to do that because it's cheaper. I also like to buy it very far term, 5 months or further away. And I explain that, of course, in the book and even in the free report that I can send you. But our cost basis over here for two of those options is $6.60. So our total invested is $26.50 or $53 here per share. That's $5,300. Okay. Now, it's guaranteed. The guaranteed value of this position, it's called a married put position because you both own the stock and the put. The guaranteed value is $25. You're going to get that out of there. Or 50 for 200 shares, you're going to get 50 back, or $5,000 back. So what is the real at risk? Per share, it's $1.50. With 200 shares at risk, it's going to be $300. $300 out of $5,300 is about 5%. So your maximum risk in this trade is 5%. But check this out. Less than 2 weeks later, I completely canceled the risk. This was January 11th. By January 23rd, I had sold two March $25 calls. The cost basis was $1.65 each. Now, that's a total income to the account of $330 or $330, when the total at risk was $300. Now, this is what I call bulletproof. There's more income into my account than I ever had at risk. Now, those calls are going to expire in March, but my stock is guaranteed until June. I may be called out and get the $5,300, the 50 for selling the stock, and the $300 I've already collected, but then I'm going to still have a put option, and the put option will still be worth something. I may use one of four other income methods. I have five whole income methods. The first one is trading with covered calls, and of course I show that for free because, well, you're already doing it if you're here. There's a brief word from our sponsor. Even without my book, I'm sure that you can see that bulletproof is an attractive place to be. and the book just details what I've learned over the last 8 years about married puts. I'd like to save you the time and trouble of learning all five of those income methods. By the way, one of those income methods is not owning a stock that pays dividends. That would be, I guess, a sixth income method. And we do have quite a few folks that are buying their married puts, selling calls against, and also collecting dividends. It's kind of a sweet proposition.